much for joining me today for this concert. I wanted to just say a little bit, just before we started, and maybe just a little bit before each piece. Usually, I don't like to talk too much when I play, because I've always felt like the music should speak for itself, and if I have to explain it, it's probably not that good to begin with. But this program's a little different. So the program is entitled Through Hardship and Loss. And like so many of you sitting here today, the last 3 years have been quite a time, full of so many struggles, some of which people around you know about, some of which you keep inside of you and you worry about late at night. For me, my real struggles started before COVID hit. In October of 2019, I played in a woodwind trio, and my colleague passed away suddenly. And that was the beginning of my time of struggle in the last 3 years. So I wanted to begin this recital with a piece that reflected that. This piece is by Jenni Brandon, and it's for woodwind trio, for oboe, clarinet, and bassoon. And I'm going to play just the second movement, which is for solo clarinet, in honor of my friend Eric.
Thank you.
evening for you deals with these hardships and with these griefs we all have and experience. And it's my hope that this time you can use to reflect on your own struggles and the struggles of those of your loved ones around you. The next piece is called Paragon by Theresa Martin. Theresa and I were classmates in graduate school at the University of Michigan. And Theresa has got to be one of the kindest, most gentle people I met when I was in school. And I learned of this piece shortly after moving here to Texas, and I really liked it. So Paragon means ideal. So what she's done is she's written a piece about the ideal life. And what she's grouped it around is she said that this starts from the beginning of your life, where you come into this world surrounded by people who love you unconditionally. And then as you get older, you move through different phases of learning, phases of joy and amusement and adventure. And then your life closes and we end back where we started, hopefully around those people that mean the most to us. This is Paragon by Theresa. Thank you. there was a point that I kind of hit my low. And I honestly started to wonder if I would ever play a recital like this again. And that kind of terrified me, because as a musician, I feel very strongly that this is my voice, this is my way I communicate in ways I can't use words. And the prospect of having that taken away from me for whatever reason is terrifying. So I started thinking, if I did play another recital, what would I program? And to be honest, I didn't think of this program. This was the last program I was thinking of. I was actually, my number one idea was to play what I call the superstar rock star concert, where it was just really loud and obnoxious and mostly on bass clarinet and a little snarky. But for a variety of reasons, we'll hold that for next time. So if I see you again, you'll probably not think it's the same person playing, because it'll have a very different tone to it. I heard this piece by Amanda Harberg, and there was something about the sound and the way she wrote that really touched me. And I listened to it a couple times, and I thought, wow, I have to get the music for this. And I had no idea what it was about. But it seemed like it was appropriate for what I was looking for. This piece was written at a very, very difficult time in Amanda's life. She had decided to write this piece, and she sat down to begin to write it, and she learned that one of her absolute closest friends died of cancer and left her husband and her little girl to live on without her. And so she says that she literally braced herself on the piano just because she was just overcome. And she played an F and a B flat. And so those two notes, the low F and low B flat, which you'll hear in the left hand of the piano, become the basis for this entire work. Again, this piece is very, very reflective. But it's quite a bit different than the piece I just played. It's in three movements. The first movement is very youthful, nostalgic, and innocent. There's a certain longing for better times that you'll hear. The second movement, you enter a very different place. It's a much more melancholy, morose kind of place. You'll hear extreme register changes. You'll hear very sparse textures at some points. You'll hear times where the phrase just stops because it can't go on. And then the third movement, it starts and it's very angry. It's very agitated, which I think is probably a normal reaction when you hear of a tragedy like that. And you'll hear this rhythmically charged motive that goes through it. But also these glimmers of the past. So, I don't listen to Mano Harberg's Sonata and just think about these things and try to identify what she might be going through when she was writing this.
Thank you.
So when I was younger, my father used to say all the time that he was a winner. And I always thought it was the most bizarre thing ever. I always thought it was a little obnoxious, and I had no idea what this whole thing was about. And in the last couple of years, I think I finally understood what he meant. For me, probably like a lot of you, my biggest fear when I'm in a really difficult, adverse situation is that I'm going to become a survivor. I don't want to be the person who's just the last one who happened to kind of gimp my way past the finish line. And so I've kind of adopted this motto for myself that I tell myself when I'm going through difficult times, that you will never be a survivor because you are a winner. And this piece by Kevin Putz, I feel like it epitomizes that. It's called Will and Legions Will Rise. And he writes that when he was composing this piece, he imagined an army gathering inside of you to fight on your behalf on your way. So he said he imagined it was like a blockbuster movie, like The Gladiator or something, and the forces are mounting. But also at the same time, the adversity is coming at you and gunning you down. This piece, you will definitely hear both of those things. It's, in some ways, it's incredibly oppressive in its rhythmic dissonance, and you'll hear figures that are shifted and then shifted again, and it seems almost like chaos. But by the end, you emerge as a winner. So I would just encourage you, as you go out in the world and leave this recital, if you just realize you're not alone, everybody has all these struggles. We just don't talk about it on Facebook. We only talk about the sunny, rosy things. But everyone faces real horrible things. And the people around you are that legion who are here to help you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.